Did your subject matter change when you were in London, when you were away from India?
Not considerably, but to some extent, I suppose. I don't really, because after seeing all those medieval things and various kinds of artifacts in the museums, I got interested in certain things which I wanted to do. I didn't immediately start doing them, but then, yeah, that sort of thing. So, the experience did make an impact, but all these things I had been already thinking about earlier, so, yeah.
Do you think you'd already achieved something as an artist, even at that time, or do you feel that most of it is after that?
Well, concept-wise, yes, but I knew that at that time that there were various things I wanted to do for it, I had to still get prepared better. And I was not too sure which direction I had to go. So, it took me some time. I had already started working with various materials at that time, but then not to the extent I did later. And I had already noticed from the museums that each kind of art object has its own kind of accent and linguistic accent. And artists can use them to their benefit. And if they understand what had to be done. And that is what I've been doing since, this sort of.
I hinted earlier that your language, your early language experience, could have some effect on that thinking.
That's right. True. It is quite true. And then this question of the various dialects in a sort of a whole tradition was in my mind even before I decided to be an artist. In fact, like I was interested in what was happening in Santiniketan, even when I was studying economics. It was in the Presidency College Library that I discovered Ananda Kumar Swami and his medieval Sinhalese art. Probably it was a very polemical book. And he wrote various things which I might not fully agree with. But the thesis he presented was very attractive to me. That when you are talking about, of course, he was showing medieval Sinharitat, but the art he was talking about was of the 17th and 18th centuries. I mean, it is not medieval in that sense. So he was thinking of what medieval as a site of a corpus of art which had that kind of spirit of interrelationship. Then it started me thinking on certain lines. One thing, what is called tradition? Generally, we think in terms of tradition in the kind of, let us say, a sort of an upward line or a downward line. It comes from one to the other in terms of various successions. But then there is in tradition a horizontal line where various kinds of activities reinforce each other and probably borrow from each other or influence each other, give each other the kind of personality, composite. And you can see that in traditional India or maybe in traditional Europe. And so that was what interested me from that time onwards. So when I came here and then I saw the various things in the European museums and came back, then I suddenly had a great desire to know about what is happening among the traditional artisans and craftsmen. That is why soon after I came back from England, I thought I should take a break. So, and the chance came quite readily. I mean, people wanted me to work for them. I had an offer from the Handicrafts Board, another from the Handloom Board. So, I joined the Handloom Board for 2 years and then went around and found that it was greatly educative, at least for me. And I did an amount of work with the young people that were hired at that time, and we became great friends and did something worthwhile. But I also learned in the process that to work within a government setup is very difficult and very frustrating. and whatever you did is almost brushed under the carpet. For the reason that certain kind of other agencies work to each one's benefit and the government doesn't sort of work. So after about 2 years of this educational break, I thought I would come back to Baroda. That's how I came.